I trust you're having a wonderful summer, and I would like to take this opportunity to update you regarding the University of the Virgin Islands School of Medicine. We have just completed our much-anticipated accreditation site visit. The LCME sent three very senior academic physicians from the mainland, as well as an administrator, and they interviewed over a four-day period close to 60 physicians, PhDs, and administrators. In addition, they toured the clinical facilities on St. Thomas and St. Croix. Their next step is to submit a report to the LCME board, which unfortunately doesn't meet until mid-October, so we won't know for sure about our accreditation until that time. They asked appropriately very tough questions, but I felt that we were well prepared. So much so that we have made the decision to move ahead with construction and preparing for recruitment of the first class to start in 2016.
We were very delighted to have the representatives from the Liaison Committee for Medical Education to come and spend 4 days with us. As I've said over and over again, this is a collective project. It is a territory-wide medical school that we're trying to develop. They understand instinctively that the two local hospitals and the various clinics that we have designated as the sites for the students to receive their clinical education are also critical partners.
I am also very pleased to let you know the Governor MAP has come out very strongly in public in support of our medical school. This was an important announcement, and we really thank him and his administration for their decision to support us so strongly.
After looking at all of the issues contained regarding the medical school, its financing, its ability to operate, its ability to construct its facilities, and more importantly, its ability to deliver towards the improvement of the healthcare system in the Virgin Islands and produce competent and high-end physicians, we announced that Lieutenant Governor Potter and I, Dr. Hall, we are fully on board. We look forward to working with you and the university family, as with the people of the Virgin Islands, to ensure that this next chapter for the University of the Virgin Islands be as bright and successful and as proudful for the people of the Virgin Islands as this university moves forward in opening, operating, running a medical school and producing top-rate physicians. You have our support.
The medical school classroom building will be close to 29,000 gross square feet and will be based on St. Thomas. And we have to have the construction completed by August of 2016. The cost of the building will be $11 million supported by the territory. The simulation center is part of the medical school beyond St. Croix, and the facility is close to 19,000 gross square feet at a cost of $8 million. So this is where the simulation center is going to be located, and it will be opening in 2016. And you can see it's right next to the RT park, because our plan is that both institutions will work closely together. The simulation center will train physicians in the latest surgical techniques. It will train first responders, whether EMS, National Guard, Coast Guards, and other individuals. It will train medical students and nurses regarding the latest approaches to medicine as well as patient safety. We believe that it will have a dramatic impact on the economy of St. Croix. It will be managed by CAMLS, which is a simulation center in Tampa, probably the leading simulation center in the United States. Just understand that the impact of CAMLS on the economy of Tampa has been dramatic. Just in the last 12 months alone, CAMLS booked close to 24,000 hotel rooms. I fundamentally believe that the new medical school will have a dramatic impact on the quality of care for the people of the region. I fundamentally believe that the medical school will have a very positive impact on the economies of both St. Croix and St. Thomas. And last but by no means least, I think that the medical school will have a very dramatic impact on the university itself, giving opportunities to young people in ways that they had never thought of before. It is my privilege to be part of this journey. I look forward to hearing from you. You will see on the screen my email address and cell phone number. Please feel free to contact me at any time. Look forward to seeing you again in the fall. Thank you.